Counter-Strike has had lots and lots of maps created for it over its lifespan. Many of them have come and gone from releases, some dearly missed by the community, and others not so much. There are a few of these maps that have managed to stay as an integral part of CS since its original 1.6 release. Dust 2, Inferno, and Nuke are some of these maps that come to mind for most people, each receiving some upgrades both to layout and aesthetics. But there's one other map that has controversially managed to stay in every mainline Counter-Strike since its inception. CS Office. So let's take a look at one of Counter-Strike's most controversial maps, its history, how it managed to stay so popular despite staying the same, and why many people are torn between loving it and hating it. But first, some history. Yeah, don't worry, it's brief. Office was first seen in Beta 7 for Counter-Strike and was originally created by the Russian-American mapper Alexander Manilov, who also originally created another well-known classic CS map, Prodigy. Office is a winter-themed map that takes place in, you guessed it, an office complex, where the T's have taken the employees hostage and the CTs are to go in and rescue them. Who would have guessed it, right? The first beta version of Office is really the only version where major layout differences are visible, and trust me when I say it feels like an entirely different map. Instead of bathrooms, there's a vent from the soda machine hall that splits out to either side. The CT spawn garage isn't present, and instead there's a connector at the front stairs that connects to the back stairs of garage. Instead of the long hall leading to T spawn, there's a whole other part of the building containing another hall and the president office that connects to the front part of the building near Snowman. I can't really say if this version was more balanced, but I have my doubts as it definitely gives off unfinished vibes. Although, I will say that some of these differences would be interesting if combined with the current version of Office that we have today. I actually wish there was more to say here for changes past this, but since the changes that came to some of the later beta and full releases for the original Counter-Strike, the map has quite literally stayed identical in terms of layout. I walked about each version for quite a while trying to note any actual changes, but other than that of the graphics and other aesthetics and details of the map, its fundamentals remain the exact same. The CS 1.6 version of Office is the last version where any noteworthy changes were made, and moving on to Condition Zero, Source, Global Offensive, and now CS2, we are effectively playing the same map just with progressively better presentation. Since I made my last map video about Vertigo, I was surprised to see many people actually loved it, and instead went on to say how other maps are much worse. One of these common opinions, of course, being CS Office. Goldak made an interesting video about the tight-knit group of players that almost exclusively play Office, and sometimes would regularly see each other just random queuing in CSGO due to the lack of people queuing to play the map in the first place. So there are obviously people out there that still enjoy not only the nostalgia of the old map, but actually playing it quite a bit. With the history out of the way, as stated, the map layout in all versions is nearly the same and pretty simple. CTs start in the garage outside with two ways of entry, the front or the back of the building, while the T's start in the very back of the enclosed office space with two main entrances to the back rooms to guard. Main hall near the elevators and the long hall leading toward the back side of the building. Now, with such a simple layout, you would expect the map to play well, right? Well, it's a mixed bag for a few reasons. First of all, the maps present in the Hostage Rescue mode throughout Counter-Strike's lifespan have usually had some issues with balancing. Hostage is a much less popular mode in newer Counter-Strike titles, which can obviously be seen by the maps added to the game over time. As of right now, CS2 has a pretty limited pool of maps, and only one of them, Office, is of the Hostage Rescue category in competitive. The mode is somewhat unbalanced by nature. The T's often spawning right beside the hostages, needing little to no setup time, while the CT's had to trek across the map to get there. The T's have little reason, if any, to actually leave the hostage area unless choosing to play unnecessarily aggressive, which obviously opens the door for lots and lots of camping. So while it's true that many of Office's problems come from the nature of the hostage rescue mode, the map's layout really doesn't do it any favors either. The CTs have only two very small corridor entrances to get into where the T's are holding the hostages. Both can be held with a few tight and wide angles by the T's long before the CTs even would make it there. Two well-placed ops, or dare I say it, auto-snipers, and the CT approach is entirely cut off. No flanking routes, and even though utility is an option, the lack of open overhead area means that the nades are pretty hard to use unless you have a direct view of the angle you're trying to throw the nade at. This aside, if the CTs make it through these corridors, the amount of hiding spots the T's have is an absolute nightmare to deal with in certain cases, bringing us to the point of the notorious head glitch in FPS games. Kitchen has one of the worst head glitch locations in any CS map. The vending machine near the corner gives the D's a perfect close angle to take out any CT approaching through the paper room. This was more than likely accomplished with the good old auto shoddy. And in the back conference room, the T's could sit crouched behind the large desk or just pick a corner to sit and wait for the CT's arrival. In the main office area, there are various counters and pieces of furniture for the T's to hide behind, most notably the hostages themselves. Long haul can easily be held with an op from the end of the hallway or at the end of the side hall, also making the CT approach that much more difficult. Balancing aside though, there are also many areas of office that mostly go unused and are widely considered to just be fluff in the map's design, like the windowed sniper area near CT spawn, which does give a clear view into the main hall, but often the T's won't even go and move out of the small back region of office, and since it's so far out of the way, it's rarely used. Another area being the underground connector to Snowman, both of which are rarely used as far as I've seen. While it does provide the CTs with more covered approach instead of the ladder, it's usually not worth the extra time spent. But the question is, why has office remained in its current state for so long, even with the complaints of balancing? While I can't say for certain, there are two main reasons here I think play a role. Firstly, it's one of the classic hostage rescue maps that has been featured in every mainline CS game with little to no changes, and Valve removing it from competitive would mean the hostage mode itself would literally be gone from current CS. And even if Valve were to give Office a rework, I think this would also be controversial. Given that the map has remained the same for so long, they would risk alienating the old fans of the map for the possible benefit of players enjoying its new changes. So, unfortunately, I really don't see a rework as a possibility. Secondly, it's just simple. I would argue probably one of the most simple CS maps. It's a regular office building with rooms and hallways. Nothing really out of the ordinary, and is pretty easy to learn all things considered, making it accessible to newer players even with its seeming lack of balance. As I did with my last video on D-Vertigo, I would like to propose what I think could be changed or tweaked in office to make it a bit more balanced. For the main changes, having a separate, simple entrance for the CTs into the back office area would change the dynamic of the map entirely. Maybe near bathrooms or somewhere in the long hall. Opening up the back office area so the CTs have a greater line of sight when peeking would also be a viable change as well to reduce the amount of close corners to peek. As for a smaller change, opening up this garage door directly to Snowman and removing the connector would be faster and allow the path to be a bit more viable. The interesting thing here is that although office is widely seen as being quite unbalanced, I couldn't really think of a big list of things to change. These few little tweaks are just my opinion on how the map could be made more accessible to players who otherwise don't like it. Well, as to my thoughts on office, I think I hold a somewhat controversial opinion. In that nostalgia aside, I actually do like the map. It's one of the few winter-themed maps we've seen in recent CS, and of course, it's a classic. Although I'm mostly playing Premier in CS2, which office isn't a part of, I really wouldn't mind seeing it being added to the Premier pool to see how it would play if more people actually wanted to. But like I said before, office really hasn't changed over the years, and the reason most likely being that Valve doesn't want to fundamentally change an otherwise classic map. But I guess sometimes things are best left unchanged.